Hello dear friends, welcome back to my channel, myself Sonali Devne. I am here to discuss one more topic from micromeritics in this video. So let's start. In this video, I am going to discuss about method for determination of particle size. And generally, there are mainly four methods which are used to determine the particle size in micromeritics. These are optical microscopy, sieving method, sedimentation method, and conductivity method. Now, start with the first method for particle size determination, that is optical microscopy. This optical microscopy is generally used to determine the particle which are in the range of 0.2 to 100 micrometer. This optical microscopy gives the number and distribution, and which is then may be converted into the weight distribution if we need it. This optical microscopy is generally used to determine the particle size in suspension, aerosol, and immersion. Generally, the optical microscope lens has a limited resolving power. Hence, for determination of a particle size, which are very fine particles, in that case, we also use the advanced microscope, that is the ultra microscope or electron microscope, scanning microscope or transmission electron microscope, etc. When we use optical microscopic method for particle size determination, then generally we consider three types of diameter, that is projected, Martens and Ferret diameters. So what is the meaning of this projected diameter? See, suppose this is the spherical particle and this is the asymmetrical particle. So when we calculate the surface area of this asymmetrical particle, when the surface area of this asymmetrical particle is equals to the surface area of this spherical particle, then the diameter of this spherical particle is known as a projected diameter, and it is denoted in number 3 in figure. Next one is the Martin diameter. This Martin diameter is defined as it is the length of a line that bisects the particle image. So in simplest way, suppose it is a asymmetrical particle. So it is the length of a line. So this is the length which bisects this particle is known as a Martin's diameter. One condition is there for Martin diameter is that this line may be drawn in any direction. Here we can draw in such a way, we can also draw like this, we can also draw like this, but the line must be same in direction for all particles. Next, in figure, it is represented by number 2. So this is the Martin's diameter. Next one is the Ferret diameter, and this Ferret diameter is defined as it is the distance between two tangent on opposite side of a particle parallel to some fixed direction is known as a Ferret diameter, and in figure it is denoted by number 2. See in figure, suppose this is the asymmetrical particle, and for this asymmetrical particle we draw the two tangent in opposite direction. Okay, so these are the two tangent, first one and second one. These two tangent must be opposite to each other and must be parallel, and then the length between these two particle, sorry, the length between these two line is known as a Ferret diameter. When we use optical microscopy for particle size analysis, then first we have to calibrate the ocular micrometer, and why there is need to calibrate this ocular micrometer? So reason is here. First one is the ocular micrometer division has no unit, and if we change the magnification of optical microscope, then the value of each division on ocular microscope is also changes. Second one is stage micrometer are very accurate, and we cannot place specimen as well as stage micrometer on a single slide. Hence, we have to calibrate the ocular microscope. This calibration will determine how many millimeters are represented by one division on a ocular scale. Here in figure you can see that this is the scale of a ocular microscope and this is the stage micrometer. In second image you can easily see that this 10 division of a stage micrometer is equals to the 0.1 mm. So one division of a stage micrometer is equals to the 0.01 mm. So when we calibrate, we consider the how many division of a stage micrometer is equals to how many division of a ocular micrometer. So here in this figure you can see that one division of a stage micrometer is equals to 10 division on ocular microscope. So 1 divided by 10 into 0.01 millimeter, that is the value of one division of a stage micrometer, and the value is 0.001 millimeter, that is 1 micrometer. Next, suppose if we have to calculate the particle size of any species, see the figure number 3. Here, we can easily calculate the particle size, that is, this is the ocular microscope. So, as per ocular microscope, this particle have a 34 division. So, particle size of this species is equals to 34 into 1, that is the calibration factor which is obtained from here, and 1 into 34 is equals to 34 micrometer. Hence this species have a particle size, that is the 34 micrometer. Here is the procedure for optical microscopy. First we have to calibrate the ocular micrometer with the help of a stage micrometer. Then powder whose size to be determined is dispersed into a suitable vehicle in which it is not solubilized. Then this sample is mounted on a slide and near about 625 particles are counted with the help of a ocular microscope. After that, size frequency distribution curve such as normal, log normal and cumulative frequency curve are plotted and calculate the statistical diameter of a powder, that is the arithmetic mean diameter, then geometric mean diameter, etc. Already it is explained in the last video. For detail you can watch that video. In description box I will give the link for that video. These are some advantages and disadvantages of this optical microscopy. Advantages: we can easily determine the aggregated particle, then easily determine the contamination. Also, we can easily stop the motion of particle by using a cover slip. Then disadvantages: it is a slow method, time consuming, tedious method, result is inaccurate and it is not reproducible. Then number of particles to be measured is more, and the main disadvantage is we can only determine the diameter of a particle in 2D, that is the two dimension, only length and width we can determine. So what is the depth and thickness of particle we cannot measure. Next method for particle size determination is a sieving method. It is generally used for particle which are in the range of 50 to 1500 micrometer. It is simplest method and it is widely used. This method directly gives a weight and distribution. This method have application in a tablet and capsule, because in tablet and capsule we generally require a 15% of a fine powder to achieve a good flow property, and for that we use this sieving method in tablet and capsule. By using this method, we can generally determine the percent of a coarse, moderate and fine powder present in a powder mixture. For easy understanding of this sieving method, we have to know that what is the meaning of a sieve number. So sieve number is nothing but a number of holes present in 1 inch. It is known as a sieve number or mesh number. Suppose in this 1 inch, suppose there are 10 holes, then the size of that sieve is 10. If the number of opening present in this 1 inch is 44, then sieve number is 44, like that. In sieve analysis method, we use the different sieve size. Here these sieves are arranged like this, means the core sieve at a top and a final sieve is placed at a bottom on a collector tray. Then this whole assembly is placed on a mechanical shaker. The powder whose particle size is to be determined is placed on a upper sieve. Then this sieve set is subjected to the mechanical vibration for a specific time period. After this time, the powder retained on each sieve is wetted. The particles are considered to be retained on the sieve mesh with an aperture corresponding to the sieve diameter. And by using this data, we can easily calculate the different distribution curves and we can easily calculate the geometric mean diameter of a powder. For easy understanding of a sieve analysis, consider these are the three different sieve, that is the sieve number 6, 8 and 12, which have a aperture opening, that is 3360, 2380, 1680 respectively. This three sieve set is placed on a mechanical shaker and then we add a powder whose particle size or particle size distribution is to be determined on a upper sieve. Okay, so the particle which having a particle size less than 3360 is easily passed through this first sieve, and the particle whose size is less than 2380 is easily passed through the sieve number 8. The powder whose particle size is more than 3360, these are retained on a upper sieve, and whose particle size is 2380 or more than this, these are retained on sieve number 8, like this. After the completion of a required time period, weight on each sieve, and the particle weight on each sieve is determined, and then we easily calculate the weight and distribution, and that gives the undersize weight distribution. Then what is the mean diameter of that particles? So mean diameter is nothing. Here we calculate the mean of 3360 and 2380, and like that we calculate the mean for all the sieve. And by using this mean diameter, we can easily calculate the geometric mean diameter. These are the some advantages and disadvantages of a sieving method. Advantages are, it is a inexpensive, simple method, rapid method. It gives a reproducible result. And disadvantage is, if the powder is moist, then it may easily block the aperture of that sieve. Then due to the mechanical shaking, there may be the particle size reduction, which gives a inaccurate result. Then lower limit is 15 micron, means below the 15 micron we cannot determine the particle size. Next method for particle size determination is sedimentation method. In this method, generally the particle which are in the range of 1 to 200 micrometer is easily calculated. The diameter is expressed as a strokes diameter. In this method, the powder is dispersed into a suitable solvent in which it is not solubilized, and some wetting agent or deflocculating agent is added to a suspension to prevent the flocculation formation, because the flocculation formation directly affect on a sedimentation rate. In sedimentation method, we consider the Anderson pipette method. This is a most popular method, and this method is first described by scientists Anderson and Lundberg, hence it is known as a Anderson pipette method. In this method, we use the 1% suspension of powder in a suitable liquid, and in that we also added a deflocculating agent to prevent the flocculation formation. Then this suspension is placed into this container, and after some time period, this suspension or a dispersed particles are trying to settle down. And this rate of settle down is directly proportional to the density of a particle as well as a size of particles. Then after the specific time period, the sample from a container is withdrawn with the help of pipette and three-way tap. This withdrawal sample is subjected to a centrifugal process or drying process, and after that weight of each dried powder is noted down, and it gives a direct undersize determination. By using this weight distribution data, we can easily plot the different particle size distribution graph. By using Anderson pipette method, we can easily calculate the Stokes diameter, and for that we can use this formula, that is V is equals to H upon T is equals to D square in bracket rho S, that is the density of a particle minus density of a fluid, into G, that is acceleration due to gravity, divided by 18, that is the factor eta naught, that is the density of a dispersion medium. Then this equation is rearranged in terms of a DST, that is the Stokes diameter. And by using this equation, we can easily calculate the Stokes diameter of a asymmetric particle. Next method for particle size determination is conductivity method. In that we see the electrical stream sensing zone method, that is the Coulter counter method. In this method, we determine the particle which are in the range of 0.5 to 500 micrometer. In conductivity method, diameter is expressed in a volume diameter. It is a pictorial representation of Coulter counter method. Here you can see it is a pump, then it is a inner glass tube, it is a outer glass tube. This inner and outer glass tube contains a same electrolytic solution. Only difference is that in outer electrolytic solution, it also contains a dispersed particle whose particle size is to be determined. Then there are a two oppositely charged electrode which is helpful to generate a electricity. Then here is a small orifice is attached. When the particle is moved from this orifice, then there is ultimately change in the voltage, and due to change in voltage, a resistance is also changed, and due to change in this resistance and voltage, the signal which is produced on a analyzer is also changed. Means if the particle is small, then on the analyzer it shows a small peak. If the particle is bigger, then on analyzer it shows a big size peak. Like that we can easily calculate the particle size. This pump attached to the glass tube which pumps a known amount of electrolyte from the outer solution, that is a fixed volume of outer solution to the inside of a glass tube through a small orifice. Means this outer solution is pumped to the inside through this small orifice. During this movement of electrolyte, suspended particle also enters through the orifice, but it constructed so well that only one particle can pass at a time. Means this orifice is constructed in such a way that only one particle is passed through that orifice. Now, when a particle enters a orifice, it displays its own volume of electrolyte and it causes a short time change in resistance across the orifice. Due to this voltage change, there is the change in signal on a analyzer. Now, discuss with some advantages and disadvantages of this Kalter counter method. Generally, the advantages are it gives a number distribution and this particle volume measurement can be converted into the diameter. It is a accurate method, it is sensitive and it is a very fast technique. Generally, 4000 particles per second can be counted. The main disadvantage of this method is it is very expensive. I hope you understand this lecture. If any query, you can message me. Thank you.